represents a growth to another level of development. But I have a few questions to ask him in a reply which was, there was a question in Rajya Sabha. It was asked, and after that there was an unstarred question in Rajya Sabha 2520 on 15-7-2009. In that, the Honorable Minister had replied, the question was, if so, this is about the shipping, about workers and the infrastructure. And in part B it is, whether the workers in the shipbreaking yards are reported to be facing health hazards due to negligence of waste disposal practices. The answer is there are no such reports received. In part C, there is, if so, the details. So he said it does not arise. And in D and E is even more interesting, whether there is an urgent need for regulatory framework for shipbreaking industry in this country, and if so, what steps is this government taking? And the reply is, regulatory framework for shipbreaking industry is already in place for shipbreaking code revised to 2013. So I just have a very question to the Honorable Minister. If he already has a 2013 code, which you think is already covering everything, do we really need a new bill? Is it a contradiction of 2013 vis-a-vis this bill? Are you going to integrate it? If it was already strong, why did we need another bill? And could we have not the Hong Kong agreement that we could have just included it in it? So why this whole exercise is my first question to the Honorable Minister. A lot has been said about the commitments internationally that we have made. But I have two or three questions about this. You in your introductory said that if when there are 1,000 ships, 300 come to India for recycling. Now we all know what the status of recycling is. I come from a constituency which is 50% urban and 50% rural. I barely can get things done which is like waste. If we talk about garbage waste. Now in garbage waste, we find it so difficult to make sure cities are clean. We have issues with medical waste. We have issues with electronic waste. So when we are barely dealing and we don't have solutions like this, this is a big step. If it's going to help the country, I mean, of course we are going to support it. But do we really have the infrastructure? And I don't want my country to be a dumping ground, because China, Korea, none of those countries are looking at this as a business opportunity. There's a difference in recycling and dumping. So I think the government must assure us that this is, India is not going to be a dumping ground by signing any of such international agreements. Another question is what you said about steel. He said that this is going to help us in recycling and it will help the economy. I think we all know what the situation of the economy is, and we all know where the steel business is doing. India, the steel business is almost at the rock bottom. So by 10% more, how it's going to help all of us, I am unclear. If you could kindly guide me of how this steel is going to improve here. The other two, three questions which I want to ask the Honorable Minister, which are again in one of these data of these questions, is in the last 2 years, the industry has slumped. It was 64 crores is what we made last year, and this year it has gone down to 47. The state where I come from, Maharashtra, Maharashtra is even further slumped. So if this business is going down, why was it going down? Why are we putting in so much money into infrastructure and dumping? This is all interconnected. So I see really no reason how there's going to be growth, because in the last 3 years, this industry has shown no growth. This is what your reply is itself saying, that it has gone down. So if you could kindly throw some light on it. Now the other two, three small questions I have in this is in another reply you have also said, which was about deaths in shipping yards. Ram Mohan, who's going to speak, I think, later on this bill. Every year there are several deaths in this. This entire business that there is. And in Gujarat Maritime Board, there is a 12-day mandatory safety training program which does not exist. This is in your reply itself. Mumbai and Kolkata are employed directly by the shipbreakers, and ports are not connecting with imparting of bills. So in Gujarat, there is a certain rule, but in Maharashtra and Mumbai, our laborers are under different rule. So safety, security of all labor should be equal. So are you going to step in to make this change? This is in your reply of a question 871 on 21st of November 2019. While we are, so this authority question, recycling, and one more question is about the authority. Now, who will be the competent authority? I have serious concerns. It's left very vague. There is some authority to the state, some to the center. So won't there be a conflict? I mean, I don't want it to go the RTI way, because in RTI you all made so many amendments. After making the amendment, it's up to the government. Today you are in power, so it suits you. You're not going to be in power. Nobody's in power forever. So there should be no misuse of any kind of legislation ever. So please, if you could clarify, because once you have done it in RTI and today, the whole idea of bringing an RTI act was to bring in more transparency. You made an amendment and have made it completely selective. So today, even if somebody like me, who's a member of parliament, wants data, it's very difficult to get data. And it's not necessarily only to criticize you. It is to improve our work also to get data. So if you put authorities like this, this could be the same way as the RTI amendment. So if you could kindly clarify your stance as how is this authority going to work. So then they will use it and use it according to their own whims and fancies.
Authority is a joint secretary, nothing more.
And then he will have the flexibility of being the judge of the situation. So there may be times there will be repeated offenders. Now who is going to decide that it is fair and transparent if information is not available? You have an authority. You are saying you will tax any of these companies who are not following the norms. But who is going to judge it? And if so much information is held back, and the concern is clearly about pollution and global warming, you know what we are going through as a country. And this is not something, I mean, I compliment Bharti Behn in her speech. She talked about what happened in her own constituency. Five people died is what she said when the shipyard accident happened. So we have to make sure it doesn't happen again. And I repeat again and I reiterate that please do not make India a dumping ground. You have to reassure all of us that this will not help. And last point is about the labor code. Now how are you going to compare it? Because the 2019 labor code is not mentioned anywhere in the bill. Now you're talking about protection of labor. Now I showed you the disparity itself in your organization between Gujarat, Maharashtra and West Bengal. Now if you're going to bring them under one, there is no clarity in the bill. The labor code bill 2019 is not. So now will you, first you have the code, now you've brought this new bill. Again, when the labor laws come, how will you get integrated? So will you bring this bill again? So I think there has to be clarity, because I appreciate, I'm not saying your intention is bad. Your intention may be very, very good to bring in this bill. But I think the labor's health, safety and working conditions are most critical. And this also, this entire business of shipbreaking has a lot of fluctuation. So a lot of times, this labor has no work. So how will you make sure they have something or skill them to a level where they have work 365 days? I think if you, these are a few points that I would like to for you to highlight, because when you say it, a clear signal goes to the entire country what you have in mind for this industry. I'm sure your intent is very good, but I feel when it comes to pollution, when it comes to labor laws, it's very, very critical that you think this through. I completely support this bill. Any development for this country, I think we unanimously must support them. But before you implement these kind of things, this is not just an investment of a car making. You talk about make in India. This is not make in India. This is dump in India. So you have to assure us that you will make sure no dumping takes place, because we are not building a shipbuilding yard here. This is all old ships which are coming to my country. So I expect Mandavia ji is a very responsible minister. He spoke exceptionally well today in his reply. So I hope he will clarify all my doubts. And I stand here, once all this is clarified, we will wholeheartedly, the NCP will support this bill. Thank you.